Hello, today I will show you the building planning regulations major. I will show you what is the site classification, proviso, and site coverage. Most likely you will understand this is a there's a three types of class. The first one is class A. Normally we say this is only one specific street if not less than 4.5 meter. For the class B size, we need to make sure this is a corner size with at least two streets and at least 4.5 meter wide. And also, you need to ensure the street at least at 40% of the boundary of the site are bus on the street. For the car C, you need to understand at least three streets with more than 4.5 meters, and the percentage is more than 60. The first one, if you understand the requirements, for example, if you have only one street with 4.5 meter, we call class A. Make sure you need to understand even the opposite direction. If this is not the corner, it will also define as a class A size. And this is a so-called the corner size with two street with more than 4.5 meter, and you need to ensure the boundary with more than 60% or 40% for class B. And for class C is a three specific street with corner size and make sure more than 60%. This means sometimes if the site is not classified if A or B or C, building departments will use their existing proviso to determine what is the maximum proviso and site coverage. This means you can compare the existing use and try to make sure the existing use is more or less the same of the one you decide. And this is one of the typical tables to show you. For example, if the height is more than 61 and you, for example, it's domestic building and class A site, you want to find out the requirement of the site coverage. You need to understand for the 61 and class A, that means only 33.33% you can allow the for the site coverage. And you also need to understand the another terms of the height. The height is the mean level of the street and the main usable floor area. That means if this is a palm room, we don't need to measure the one above. Okay, just the usable floor area you will count. This is another term, is a so-called the proviso, is equal to gross floor area divided by site area. Another term you need to understand is, for example, the site area you already loaded, and the proviso you just build based on the building planning regulation. After that, you will see how many floor areas you can build for your site. Another thing is the so-called the site coverage is more or less, sometimes the people say it's a, imagine this is a sun directly on the top of the building. The shaded area is the so-called the site coverage, you can say. I show you one of the example. For example, if your site is only one street with 4.5 meter, we call class A site, and the site area, you can easily find out from the lease or from the surveyor, and you can find out the areas. And then if you want to build a building with more than 91% height of the building and cover the area is something like this, and you also want to do the gross floor area provider, and after that you want to find out whether we can do this is feasible or not. The first one, you need to take out the building planning regulation and schedule, the first schedule, and then you can see the class A site is a domestic building, and then you can see the restriction for the proviso is 8, and then the site coverage is 33.33, and then I show you how to check the values. Okay, from the previous requirement, you can see the restriction for proviso is 8, and the site coverage, the first one you try to find out is the proviso is equal to the GFA you provided 39, just put the cost for area you used and then divided by the site area. You can see this is the value is 7.8, that means less than 8, that means proviso is okay. For example, the requirements for the site coverage is more or less the same. The cut for the area is 1,000 feet, and then divided by the area. That means only 26, and you are allowed to have 33.3 feet. That means your building can be built. Another thing is that you need to understand sometimes your building is a domestic building. They also have a formula for this one. Most likely, you need to find out the proposal for the non-domestic first, and then based on this formula, you can see the requirement for the remaining proposal you can provide for domestic. This is one of the example in here. I show you how to do it. For example, this is Class A site, and then for the Class A site, the height is more than like this. You can see the proposal is a requirement like this. After that, you do the same for the non-domestic first and find out the proposal for non-domestic, and then use the formula. You can find out the maximum allowable proposal for the residential for the domestic, and then you just divide the domestic GFA divided by the site area. You can see the actual domestic proposal you used. After that, you can see this is also less than the requirement. That means your building is satisfied, so-called the building planning regulation. Thank you, that's it.